Hey everyone, so this is a video for anyone who got stuck in the same boat as I was just a few months ago. So I bought this keyboard from Amazon, this Logitech keyboard, and after a bit of use I noticed that the keyboard was chattering. So let me show you what I mean. So sometimes when I'm typing and pressing the space button would double tap. And a little while later I noticed that some of the keys were starting to chatter. By that I mean that I would just leave the keyboard untouched and some of the keys would press themselves. And also when typing with a keyboard you would notice that sometimes like you would press a key but another key would respond. So to fix this you would need to open up your keyboard, so keep in mind that if you were gonna do this you're gonna avoid the warranty, so if you're willing to deal with that then let's carry on. Okay, so on the webcam here you can see me working on the keyboard here, so the keyboard is plugged in on a laptop on the side there. So I'm plugging in the keyboard and checking for chatter at every step. Essentially you should do the same because you never know why you have this issue. So just, you know, before you go with extra steps, make sure to stop for a second, plug in the keyboard and see what's going on with it. So the first thing you want to do is grab some compressed air. So I just bought the cheapest thing I could find and it doesn't really matter. Next, just grab a thin, preferably blunt knife, something that isn't too sharp so you don't scratch your keyboard or dent it too hard, and gently pry off some of the keys here and apply the compressed air and see if that fixes your issue. It could be just dust. So if that doesn't help, of course, then we're gonna have to take the keyboard apart. Okay, so the first thing that you want to do is you want to take off all the keys off your keyboard, turn the keyboard around, and here you can see all the screws. I've marked them here on this image. Keep in mind that some of these will be hidden under the sticky pads, so you'll have to take them off to reach the screws. So once you've taken off the screws, you can separate the two plastic layers connecting the keyboard. Keep in mind that when you're taking off the first time, you're gonna have to snap some of the plastic holding them together, so you're gonna have to use a little bit of force here. Once you've taken off the first layer, the next one you're gonna see is the rubber domes, which are the things that you press whenever you touch any of the keyboard buttons. So if you try to press on them while the keyboard is turned on, you'll see feedback, so keep that in mind and do a little bit of testing, see if the issue is gone. What you can do now is you can take out this rubber dome, there's a little cable there on the right that holds it down, so just be careful with that, and you can take it out, there's nothing gluing it to the layers below it. And of course, what you can do with it is you can also wash it, just keep in mind that it is quite stretchy, so just be careful, don't let it stretch too hard or you'll have trouble getting it back on the keyboard. Okay, so now that we've taken off that layer, you're gonna see one of the main parts of the membrane here as shown in this image, so if you press on one of these little buttons here, you should also see the keyboard responding. So at this point, it's also a good idea to plug in the keyboard and see what's going on, maybe the issue is gone. If you're still having troubles, then what I would suggest is just taking a close look, looking around for leaks, looking around for dust, grab like a lint-free cloth and just wipe everything down. If that doesn't help, then you can actually grab the layers below and sort of gently push them off the very bottom of the keyboard and you'll be able to see what's going on there. So maybe there's some dust or water collected there or something, so be sure to check that out. At this point for me, the issue was gone, so all you have to do now is just put everything back together and you should be good to go. So yeah, thanks for watching and I hope it helped you out.